गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एट होम। एज यू ऑल आर फेमिलियर विद द करेंट सिनेरियो ऑफ आवर कंट्री ड्यू टू COVID-19, आवर स्कूल हैज स्टार्टेड विद द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस सो दैट यू डोंट फेस एनी एकेडमिक लॉस। आई एम हियर टू टीच यू द लेसन्स ऑफ सोशल साइंस। इन सोशल साइंस वी विल बी डूइंग हिस्ट्री, ज्योग्राफी, इकोनॉमिक्स। यू विल बी अटेम्प्टिंग 80 मार्क्स पेपर विच विल बी डिवाइडेड इन टू 4 सेक्शंस। सेक्शन ए 16 मार्क्स, सेक्शन बी 20 मार्क्स, सेक्शन सी 24, सेक्शन डी अगेन 20 मार्क्स इंक्लूडिंग मैथ। स्टैंडर्ड 10th हिस्ट्री इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम स्टैंडर्ड 9th। हियर विल स्टडी अबाउट द हेरिटेजेस ऑफ इंडिया रिलेटेड टू फाइन आर्ट्स, लिटरेचर, साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। बिफोर वी प्रोसीड फर्दर, टेक अ ग्लिम्स ऑफ द इंडेक्स। चैप्टर 1-7 इज हिस्ट्री, 8-14 इज ज्योग्राफी, 15-21 इज इकोनॉमिक्स। Also, before I start the chapter, important words and lines are highlighted so that you don't face any difficulties. 2 or 3 marks questions are asked from this chapter. Now, heritage. What is heritage? Heritage is generally valuable gift that you are getting from your forefather, ancestors, or even from your motherland. India is a land of ancient culture. Our Indian culture is very old one, very ancient one. Indian scripture. Scripture in Hindi means Shastra. विष्णु पुराण स्टेट्स, उत्तरम यत् समुद्र से हिमाद्र सचिव दक्षिणम वर्षणम तत् भारत नाम भारती यत्र संसति। दिस मीन्स इंडिया इज एक्सटेंडेड फ्रॉम हिमालयस इन द नॉर्थ टू द इंडियन ओशियन इन द साउथ। इट इज द न्यू डिसेंडेंट्स विच आर सेटलिंग हियर और द न्यू फैमिलीज, न्यू ट्राइब्स, दे ऑल आर कॉल्ड एज इंडियंस। भारतवर्षा, भारतखंड, जम्बूद्वीप, आर्यवर्त आर द वर्ड्स विच वी आर यूजिंग व्हाइल टेकिंग एनी रेजोल्यूशन और ड्यूरिंग एनी ऑस्पिशियस सेरेमनी। In the north, we are having Himalayan mountains and seas in the east, west and south direction, which is also a natural gift to our country. Various tribes and foreigners have come here and they have been fascinated by the Indian culture. They have come here to trade, but they have also settled and adopted Indian culture. Heritage or this culture is transferred from generation to generation and it is still passed on. Coming to the location and area of India, we have studied in standard 9th also that India is located in the Asian continent on the northern and eastern hemisphere. Area wise it stands 7th rank and population wise it is 2nd. Rich and varied heritage. India, our motherland India, has bestowed rich and varied heritage. That means it has given us variety of natural things which makes us feel proud. Our culture is trade oriented and peace loving. Trade oriented, various tribes, people, foreigners have come here and done trade activities with our country, and also they have wanted peace, so they are peace loving people. Sat, truth, chit, consciousness, anand, happiness, all these are realized from the Indian culture. We are getting these things from our Indian culture, and also mutual exchange of these culture is seen between the tribes of foreigners who have come here and settled. Principles of non-violence and peace have been adopted by our people. These two words or terms, non-violence and peace, this is the what Gandhiji also followed. Gandhiji was always on the terms and policies of non-violence and peace. So people have adopted these things from our Indian culture. People right from Indus Valley Civilization till today, they are enriching our countries with their talent, skill, abilities. Innumerable people or scholars, scientists, thinkers, they have made a lot of contribution for our culture. Now what is culture? Culture is the sum of habits, values, customs, traditions, conduct of human lifestyle. Values, habits is what you are learning from the people you are interacting, from the behavior of the people, your habits, values, all these you are when you are interacting with other people, you are learning, you are adopting their culture. Indian country is having people who are following different religions, so their customs and traditions varies. So we are following all these things. So culture is also making our life enriched. And this culture is a kind of knowledge that is passed from generations to generation to all. So culture is a way of life. Cultural heritage of India. Cultural heritage. Heritage, again I told you, it is a valuable gift which we are getting from our forefathers or ancestors and also from our motherland. Our Indian heritage is divided into two parts. Natural heritage, cultural heritage. Natural heritage is gifted from nature. Cultural heritage is man-made heritage. Cultural heritage is man-made heritage. Natural heritage shows a close relation between nature, environment, human life. It is also what you are getting from the nature. So you can include flora and fauna, ecosystems, geological structure. Nature is providing us with food, water, fresh air, place to live. It is also a gift to us so that we can survive on this earth. Stories from Panch Tantra and Jakarta tales are also an example of natural heritage. Folk music, classical music, which are used by the artists, is also part of natural heritage. Yunani, Ayurveda, these are all based on nature. Landscape, Himalaya is a beautiful example of landscapes where we can see fast flowing rivers, which are gift of Himalayas, different types of birds and animals. Amarnath, Badrinath, Kedarnath, etc. are all important pilgrimage places on the Himalayas. Rivers are also an important part of our Indian culture. Rivers are also considered as Lok Mata because we are worshipping the river Ganga. Many civilization has been flourishing on the banks of river, like Indus Valley civilization. There, you on the banks of river Indus, Harappan civilization, Mohenjo-daro civilization. All these civilization has been flourished on the banks of rivers. Rivers are also influencing people by providing drinking water, water for domestic use, for irrigation, for electricity and waterways. Waterways also provide them some source of income also. Earlier, when there was no transportation, people used this rivers for transportation. Also, industries were developed on the banks of the river. So these rivers have helped man in a variety of ways and enriched their lives. It is also an inspiration for artists and poets also. Scenes which are very beautiful at dawn and dusk is also part of natural heritage. Vegetation, human beings, animals, birds, all are depending on this vegetation, that is plants and trees, for food. Banyan and peepal tree are worshipped in India. Even foods like cereals, pulses, oil seeds, all these are given to us by forests and different plants. Then various types of medicinal plants like amla, aloe vera, tulsi, neem is given. These plants are medicinal plants which are helping us to cure different types of diseases. Fragrance giving flowers are rose, lotus, sunflower, champa, juhi. They are enriching our human life, and also these flowers are used for religious and social purpose also. Wildlife is also an important part of our natural heritage. Different animals are seen in our country. Also, these animals are given important place in our national currency, like four lions, horse, elephant, bull. Even these animals are used as a vehicles for different gods also. So till here we have done our natural heritage. Coming to cultural heritage, before I start, at the end of the chapter I have attached some images of cultural heritage so that you can recognize the images. Cultural heritage is man-made heritage, I already told you. So it is created or received by our own tact, wisdom, art and skills. Starting from Aryan, Kshatriya, Kushan, Huns, these are all Indian tribes. Persians, Turk, Arabs, Mughal, Britishers, French, these are the foreigner tribes who have come and settled here. When these people have come and settled here, we have exchanged our culture and enriched our culture also. The art of architecture and sculpture is 5000 year old. Indus Valley civilization is an example. Figures of god and goddesses, human, animals, several toys, sculpture of a beard man, you can see the image, statue of a dancer. This I have sent an image at the end of the chapter, you can see. All these are making us feel proud of our cultural heritage. Figure of a bullock or lion on the inverted lotus of Mauryan era. Statue of Gautam Buddha, I have already attached an image. So statues of Jain Tirthankar, caves of Ellora. These things, when we feel, see them, we feel proud. And across the world, when people come to visit India, they also feel proud of our country. Then various man-made heritages are there, like palaces, buildings, sculptures, viharas, statues, stupas. These are man-made heritages. Historical places are also there in our heritage, like Sabarmati Ashram, Dandi, Bardoli, Vardha, which is also part of our cultural heritage. Various discoveries have been made in our country, like discovery of zero by Aryabhatta, mathematics, environment protection, zoology and botany, which deals with the study of animals and plants, then political science, study of government system. All these are made in India, and we are while making these discoveries, it has been passed from generation to generation, and when we see these things, we feel proud of our country and our culture. Next topic, cultural heritage. Cultural heritage of Gujarat. As we are living in Gujarat, must know the importance of cultural heritage of Gujarat also. Gujarat, Lothal, Rangpur, Dholaveera, these are legendaries of Gujarat. Then pilgrimage places, they are Victory Tower of Vadnagar, Sun Temple of Modera, inscription of King Ashoka, stone inscription, you can see the image. Then Rudra Mahal of Sidhpura, Jhulta Minar, Siddhi Sayyad Nijali, all these are important places of Gujarat, Tomb of Mohabbat Khan, these are important places which you can see. Worth seeing places. Religious important places are Dwarkadakshi Temple of Dwarka, Sharda Peeth Temple of Jagat Guru Sankacharya, Somnath Temple, one of the 12 Jyotirlinga, which is dedicated to Lord Shiva, Ambaji Temple, Shamlaji Temple, all these are important places, religious places. Then tourist oriented places are Polo Forest, Kite Festival, Kankariya Carnival, Northern Dance Festival, Ran Utsav in Kutch, these are all tourist oriented places, which is also earning an income to the Gujarat government also. Tourist places of Jain and Buddhist are Vadnagar, Taranga, Khambalia, Shamlaji, Koteshwar, Talaja, Dank and Jagadia. Fairs of Gujarat, there are variety of fairs, in Hindi we say Mela. These all are also there in Gujarat, which is of both religious and social importance. Some fairs are Modera Fair, Bahujarji Fair, Shamlaji Fair, Bhavnath Fair, Madhavpur Fair, Dang Fair. These are held at different places of Gujarat and at different time. The next important part of our topic is land and people. Now different tribes or different foreigners came and settled in India. Earlier primitive men came into existence in eastern southern Africa. First of all, early men came and settled in eastern southern Africa. Then tribes started settling in India also. The first and foremost ancient tribe was Dravidians. After that, after lot of research, it was proved that before Dravidians, six more tribes came and settled in India. Among them, Negroid. I have sent an image. You can see that at the end of the chapter. They are the first inhabitants of India who were also called as the Great Hapsi people. They direct came from Africa via Baluchistan to India. Their characteristics were black complexion, height 4 to 5 feet and curly hair. Then comes Asteroids. Aryans gave them the name Nishad people. These tribes came from Southeast Asia. They were also black skin, broad head, flat nose, short in height. Then other tribes came from Assam, Nicobar, Myanmar. These tribes came from Assam, Nicobar, Myanmar. They were similar to Asteroids and their names were Kol, Munda and Khasi tribes. These tribes, they were having too much religious beliefs and they were skilled in making clay utensils. They were cotton clothes. Dravidians. Dravidians is an important topic for your exam also, question answers. The Dravidians direct, they were the creator of Mohenjo-daro and they were direct descendants of stone culture. The Dravidians, they survived with their language and cultural features. Later they were termed as Dravidians. Dravidians, they gave the concept of mother as goddesses and father as god. So these people started worshipping Parvati and Shiva as father and mother. Parvati and Shiva as mother and father. The tradition of worshipping the nature started from Dravidians. Dravidians started worshipping with dhoop, deep, aarti. Also Dravidians started worshipping the nature and animals. The whatever culture was started by the Dravidians, it was also accepted by the Aryans, and whatever culture was started by the Aryans, it was accepted by the Dravidians. Dravidians also started inter-caste marriages. In the Dravidians family, mother was the head of the family, that is why they termed this as matriarchal family system. They were skilled in building boats, raft, weaving, spinning, dyeing. The important languages were Tamil, Telugu, Kannad, Malayalam. Among them, Tamil was one of the ancient languages of Dravidian family. Mongolard, I have attached an image to this at the end of the chapter. They also came from North China via Tibet and settled in North Assam, Sikkim, Bhutan, West Bengal. These people, they were in yellow in complexion, flat face, chubby cheeks, almond-shaped eye, and they were known as Kirat. Alpine, Dinar, Ahmed. They came from Central Asia and they settled in Surat, Gujarat, Maharashtra, Bengal, Odisha. Aryans, they were the creators of Aryan civilization. The other name of Aryans is Nordic Aryans also. The Hindus were also called as Aryans. Densely populated area where the Aryans settled was Aryavarta, and the region where the seven rivers flow, it was termed as Sapta Sindhu. The Aryavarta extended up to Mithila in Bihar till Vindhyachal in the south. The Aryans named as Bharat Bhumi, Bharat Khanda, Bharat Varsha after the king Aryabharat. Characteristics Aryans, they are nature lover. They worship natural elements like trees, rivers, mountains, sun, wind and rain. They also composed hymns or rituals, that in Hindi we say mantra. They started recitations of Vedas and performing of yagnas, and these things are still prevalent. These are still, we are following in our country. So these tribes which came and settled in India, there is a fine mixture of all these things, and that all the tribes, those who came and settled here, they adopted the Indian culture, making it glorious and prosperous. Also these foreigner tribes, these tribes who came here, they started inter-caste marriages and they lost their own identity. They were so much influenced by the language, script, names, religion, beliefs, that they lost their own identity and they started Indianizing themselves, means they started adopting the Indian culture. So our Indian culture is a composite culture, that is a mixed culture of everything. The next important topic is preservation and conservation of heritage. This is also an important topic for exam. Each aspect of Indian heritage made India eye-catching, picturesque, and attractive. That is, our Indian heritage is noticeable one, very fascinated. Each and everyone is being fascinated over by Indian culture. The first and the foremost duty of every citizen is to protect our culture, heritage, natural heritage both. Because if it is destroyed or ruined, the coming generation would not be able to use it, utilize it. So these process, these steps for preservation are also mentioned in the constitution also as the duties of Indian citizens. Here under Article 51A section, subsection 6, 7, 9, we'll study the duties. First, to understand the importance of our harmonious culture, prosperity and preserve it. Whatever culture is there, we have to preserve it. Our Indian heritage is so much glorious, so much prosperous, we have to preserve it. We have to maintain or preserve all the natural elements, that is rivers, forests, tanks, ponds, wild animals. We have to preserve them so that it is not destroyed or ruined. We also have to show love for all the living creature. Even public properties must be protected and violence must be given up. Stop violence. Nature has gifted us beautiful ecosystem, so we must maintain its purity and beauty. As it is our important duty being the citizen of India, whatever achievements or development has been made in India, it is due to the efforts of people of India. Since ancient times, the nature has provided us everything in abundance, so we must use it judiciously. Lastly, India have made a lot of contribution and also achieved remarkable developments in all the fields respectively. Now here the chapter is completed. We will solve the exercise. Now while solving the exercise, you must solve it in any notebook which is available to you at present. Question answers which are marked, you will write down those in your notebooks. Even MCQs are solved for you. Note down the answers. That's your homework. Thank you.